Let's go back to our calculation of enterprise value. We split the free cash flows into non-terminal and terminal free cash flows and added the present value of these two pieces. One worry with this calculation is that the present value of the terminal cash flows is about 80% of the enterprise value. Moreover, we computed this value using a simple formula that depends only on the assumed growth rate of the free cash flows and on the weighted average cost of capital. The concern is that any small change in the growth rate or on the weighted average cost of capital would lead to large changes in our final answer. For example, if we repeat the same calculation but use instead a weighted average cost of capital of 7% and a terminal growth rate of 3.5%, we end up with a share price of $61.33. If instead we use a weighted average cost of capital of 9% and a terminal growth rate of the free cash flows of 2.5%, we end up with a share price of $33.51. The difference between these two estimates is quite large. To mitigate this concern, we can form a different estimate of the value of the free cash flows from 2023 on. Instead of using the perpetuity with growth to estimate the terminal or residual value as of 2022, we will use multiples. The following table shows the comparable firms that Evercore used to estimate the valuation multiple. These firms are comparable to Whole Foods as they are also grocery retailers, although care must be taken when using this approach since these firms might have different margins, growth rates, etc. For each firm, Evercore used current market data to compute the enterprise value to EBITDA multiple. It observed that a reasonable multiple should lie between 7x and 9.5x, with 8.25x being in the middle of the range. Management projections specify an EBITDA of $2,058 million in 2022. Using 8.25x as the multiple, we obtain a terminal value of $16,979 million. But this value is of 2022. Therefore, discounting 6 years to 2016 leads to $10,699 million. Using this alternative calculation of terminal value or residual value, the enterprise value as of 2016 is given by this formula. Note that the present value of the non-terminal cash flows is the same as before, as we are only changing the way we compute the terminal value. Plugging an enterprise value of $13,497 million in the market value balance sheet leads to an equity value of $13,572 million and a share price of $42.41.